I wanted to bring this up because, you know, as a black woman, an African-American woman here, you know, wigs and weaves and things like that are huge with us. It's a billion-dollar industry. And as someone who's going through this enlightenment recently, you know, I've had this real awakening of wearing human hair. So I'm not going to get into the spiritual aspects of that. But basically, it made me start to do my own homework and wonder why. Why do we wear wigs? Like, I've gotten to a point to where my edges are, you know, very thin. And I'm one who has been diagnosed with alopecia. So that's why I wear wigs now. But what caused me to get to that point? Because if you think about it, there are a lot of women, especially African-American women, who say they have been diagnosed with alopecia. It is a huge diagnosis in our community. And so my roots come back, or where this began with me, is I remember being 5 years old, and my aunt, who was a what we called a beautician, she would be called a hairstylist now, used to always complain about how thick my hair was. And she was like, she would say things like, I've had your head under this water for 30 minutes and it still hasn't hit your scalp yet. Or that's how thick my hair was. Or, you know, she'd be doing my hair and she would say, man, I could kick your dad's butt for giving you this thick hair. And so as a 5 year old, I started to believe that my thick nappy hair was bad. When I was also five, she took me, I used to really be with her a lot because she was, I was her sidekick and I loved her, you know, my, I was the first niece for her. So, she took me one day and put a Jerry curl in my hair. This is when Jerry curls first came out. I'm 5 years old. She didn't tell my mom. I remember this, coming home and my mom was devastated that she had put a Jerry curl in my hair. And again, those were messages that I was receiving at 5 years old, as my hair being nappy and thick wasn't good. And so I believe what has happened, and I've really denied this over the years, I've learned to hate my natural hair. And so I've always gravitated to something that wasn't my natural, authentic hair. And going through this awakening process, and then becoming open with myself and my truth, this is something that I can be open and honest with about now. I would love to get to a point to grow my natural hair back, but these were seeds that were planted that grew within me. And I believe that this is a lot of, you know, different stories, obviously, of black women who have become to, you know, believe that our natural thick hair is bad. You'll see a lot of people do videos and they're always talking about my kitchen, the beady beads. Well, we just saw a documentary of this beautiful black woman and her natural hair, and her hair was what we would call nappy, but it looked so good. It was well kept. It was healthy. And those were the things that I used to perm over. I had to straighten it, yeah. And how many of us did that?
True. That video was that documentary is called Howling the Hog. It's on Netflix, so we just watched it about 40 minutes ago.
Yeah, we saw the first episode.
Yes, I think it's four episodes, maybe five?
Yes, about four or five. Yes. We watched the Tracing Our Roots or something to that effect, and that was a really awesome episode.
So it's a good documentary for us black people to check out.
Absolutely.
It's got like four or five episodes. And Yes, we're going to finish watching the other three or four that's left. Well, two or three.
Yeah.
But we probably will discuss it on here. Maybe not. We'll see.
Yeah. But
anyway.
I heard that.
But yeah. So let me say this. So yeah, man, when you think about that and the stigma, it really was bad on young African American girls.
Yes.
But it permeated through the community.
It permeated.
Because men had a certain way they looked at it too. Everybody did.
Everybody did. So, you know, I mentioned the Jerry curls when that first came out, and then remember when everybody was perming their hair. Yeah. And so probably about maybe when I was about a sophomore in high school, I started perming my hair. And then when I could do my own hair, I was, and man, my hair was sharp all the time. My hair was my crown. And so when I was probably in my early 20s, I could perm my hair every 2 weeks or so because it had to remain bone straight. So I'm putting this lye and this relaxer in my hair. And no these lie. Are chemical. No, I used perm with lye because my hair was so thick. Remember, I was trying to make it bone straight. I didn't want any kinks. I didn't want any waves.
Yeah.
I didn't want any naps. I didn't want any of that. And I was, that was me, self-hatred.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't know that then. But yeah, so the perms, the relaxers were a huge thing with us. Yes. And then we went into weaves and wigs. And again, there is a huge amount of us that suffer from alopecia today. Mm-hmm. And the root of that is not an autoimmune disease, as people would have you believe, and we know who those people are.
Yeah.
And it is not just that we've become, you know, received this disease.
Yeah.
I believe a large part of it is the root of what we used to put in our hair.
I remember you told me something about the spirits of somebody else's hair on your head.
Yeah. So that was the part that I said I wasn't going to get into, but I will. You asked me.
Okay.
So with my my awakening process and my spiritual awakening, it just dawned on me one day that as I sew human hair, 100% human hair into my head, this was someone else's hair.
Yes.
I have no idea the trauma this beautiful woman has gone through.
True.
And spirits are in everything.
Yeah.
And so as I'm sewing her hair onto mine, those spirits can transfer. And so we as Black women need to be very cognizant of what we, how we, you know, put these things on us, even wigs.
Yeah.
There's spirits in that. And I just know that to be true.
Yeah.
Just as I've been wearing weaves and wigs, I've suffered from so many different emotions. And when I went through this spiritual awakening, it just hit me like, wow. Because I wonder, where do all these things come from? Like spirits. Well, we have many gateways that we allow spirits in to our being. And so today we're just talking about this one gateway.
Yeah.
Wigs and weaves.
Yeah.
You know, hair that's not ours. There's spirits that are attached to it. And so that's a deeper, maybe a deeper conversation, but
it is.
That was my awakening.
It's kind of like a ritual in a way, huh?
Almost in a way.
Commercialized ritual.
Yeah. And there are some women who cut their hair because they have to sell it for money to sell it to feed their family.
True.
But we, you know what? There could be several women who cut their hair or are forced to cut their hair due to trauma, through slave trade. Who knows what it is? I'm just saying that it could be someone who has experienced trauma and now the spirit of that is in her hair, and now we're putting that in our own. And so, yes, I do have a wig on today. Mm-hmm. And I'm not proud of that, but you know, I'm very transparent with it now. Most of my hair is bald in the top from the alopecia that I've been diagnosed with. I'll never say that I have alopecia. It was a diagnosis because I am going to overcome that. But I'm just saying it for the sake of we live in America.
Yeah.
And you going out being bald, there's a stigma. Mm-hmm. And I'm not quite there yet with my maturity and this walk that I'm on to be bold enough just to say, hey, I'm going to go out and I've got bald spots in my head. And this is 100% transparency for me. But this is why I have a wig on, just for that. But if I was in Belize, I'd probably be wearing head wraps.
Yeah.
And certainly not wigs. And it's just a difference in how we live here versus there.
Yeah.
And then that's a transparent reflection of just me and where I am with my maturity in this walk. And ladies, here's a tip. Guys love us in our natural being. They love our natural hair, our natural eyebrows, eyelashes, nails, bodies, all of that. So it took me to get to be 50 and start to mature and walk in wisdom to be able to receive it and accept it and now share it. So that's what I wanted to
contribute. Too late. Never too late.